This is the plain tiger, a very common species of butterflies in our dear Singapore. Have you ever stopped to observe these pretty little creatures? These flamboyant and colorful butterflies are actually a common sight in Singapore. Can you imagine life without them? How much have you done in protecting the beautiful butterflies that whiz by? Hi one and all, I am Brandon, representing my group embarking on a research to promote the awareness and appreciation of butterflies and their conservation. Singapore is currently home to over 300 species of butterflies, yet they can slowly vanish if we do not actively protect them and their homes. Butterflies play a crucial and critical role in nature and our environment, for they not only pollinate flowering plants, but are also food for other organisms such as lizards and parasitic wasps. Grasshoppers devour the leaves of host plants, leaving caterpillars in despair. In order to further investigate and enlighten ourselves about this intrinsic and delicate relationship between butterflies, people, and the environment around us, we decided to speak to Ms. Sim Aiwa from Red Swastika School. This is the butterfly enclosure of Red Swastika School. The school has been playing an impactful role in conserving butterflies. This enclosure has been converted from a bird enclosure in 2010. But the question is, why so?
Okay, initially when we had the bird enclosure, right, we're not allowed to go in because of worries about bird flu. So we thought the space was wasted. So why not convert it into something useful whereby the kids can actually go in and learn something? So the idea that came out was to work with Sentosa Butterfly Parks to convert the enclosure into a butterfly enclosure for the school. So that was how the idea came about. Then the kids can actually get to see the life cycle of the bicycle right, with your own eyes, taking place in your own school.
On whether the butterfly enclosure is part of the school's aim to conserve butterflies,
by letting children know that butterflies are actually not harmful to us in a way. Because some people may think about butterflies for allergies and all sorts of reasons, right? But actually, right, when you know that butterflies are actually they are creatures that don't carry a lot of diseases. So basically, they are quite safe to handle. And also, butterflies play a part, pollinating flowers, ensuring that there's a continuity of food supply in a way. So in a way, we're educating the kids to know that butterflies are not to be scared of. Yeah, so in a way, the more you learn about it, the less scared you are. Probably you will not try to destroy or kill it next time you see a butterfly. Then it's good to be able to see the life cycle with your own eyes. Different stages. And also some kids can actually go in and do actually experiment. You can experiment with variables like different types of food, then different types of habitats. How does it affect the life cycle of the animal itself?
This butterfly enclosure is also used for teaching purposes. The school previously had a collaboration with the Butterfly Park and Insect Kingdom in Sentosa. However, maintenance has been difficult.
The collaboration lasted about 2 years. Now we are more or less on our own already. But we have tried to make sure that we can sustain the cycle throughout the year. But the thing about butterflies is the life cycle is very short. So usually about within 1 month, right, that one cycle, after it emerges from the pupa state, right, usually you can only survive about 2 weeks to about probably a month. So within this period of time, you must make sure it lays eggs. Then other than that, the major challenge for us is actually sustaining the cycle. Because we managed to do it we have butterflies in the enclosure until about May this year, which I think is an improvement from previous years. So the thing about when you try to have butterflies in captivity, it's a bit more challenging. Because you may not get to see, they will come to a time whereby you have no more already. They all die out naturally. We have seen improvements. Last year when we had it, right, we only probably sustain about 1 to 2 months, then that's it. Then this year we managed to sustain all the way until May, which is about 5 months. So the species of butterfly actually matters. Some are more fragile, some are more hardy, they survive better. Meaning-wise, basically butterflies actually they are quite clean creatures actually. Yeah, they may have droppings, but maybe their droppings are very, very small. So we did a wash up recently, but other than that, we just leave it on.
So it's like you just go in.
Every day we'll go in if there are butterflies, right, then we spray the ground to make sure that when it evaporates, that there's this draft, there's this drift, right, that can actually help the butterfly fly. But other than that, we just leave them alone.
Yeah. So But the
actually, it's very much low maintenance. It's more of a matter of making sure that if there are lime plants, right, and the lime plants are all the leaves are almost all being eaten up already, right, bring in new supply, so that the food doesn't run out. Yeah.
Due to their pivotal role in nature, the extinction of butterflies may lead to a dire ramification, that is, a severe imbalance in the ecosystem, detrimental to all the organisms that directly or indirectly interact with butterflies. The food web and the web of life will be greatly affected by the extinction of butterflies. The complete die-out of butterflies will prove adverse to its regular predators, such as snakes and birds, and will also negatively impact the predators of its predators, with the end result being that the equilibrium of the ecosystem is extensively disrupted. As like most other animals, butterflies are prey, and animals and insects rely on them and caterpillars for nutrition. Caterpillars also will be extinct because they are part of the life cycle of butterflies. Caterpillars consume almost 20% of the leaves, which gives other organisms a chance to obtain indirectly the same nutrition. Butterflies are definitely an instrumental aid in the process of pollination and contribute to the distributing of pollen and the seeding and blooming of trees and flowers. Humans are vital in the protection and sustaining of our environment. That doubtlessly includes the conservation of butterflies. Having affirmed our need to conserve butterflies, how are we going to go about doing it? We all know that butterflies need nectar, but if we really want them to stay close to our wildlife gardens, we have to plant host plants for caterpillars. Most butterfly larvae are specialists. That means they will only eat one plant or plants from just one family. The adult butterflies lay eggs in specific host plants. Due to their substantial importance of host plants to butterflies, the destructions of host plants will have significant major adverse impacts on butterflies. For example, a study suggested that the number of extinct butterfly species in Singapore increased in line with the number of extinct plants. Out of 908 host plants and 383 butterfly species, at least 208 plants and 56 butterflies have gone co-extinct with butterflies. This is indeed a much prevalent, staggering, and perhaps even mortifying trend. Considering the heightened role of butterflies in nature, we as human beings must do our best in conserving and protecting these butterflies. We must understand that men do play a paramount role in affecting the populations of butterflies, for men can directly affect the breeding of their host plants and thus also the butterflies. To ensure the conservation of butterflies' habitats, do not destroy plants where butterflies frequent or lay eggs on, and try to grow nectar on producing plants so as to attract and support the lives of butterflies. To learn more about butterflies, to observe them, or simply to contribute one's own little part to the conservation of these beautiful, fluttering insects, one can actually grow a couple of host plants around his or her home. This may attract butterflies and they may lay eggs, and one can henceforth observe a fascinating life cycle. Otherwise, one can visit parks and places all around Singapore more abundant in the population of butterflies. An example would be the Tampines Changkat Butterfly Garden. The Butterfly Garden is a garden opened on the 13th April 2011. It is a new eco-friendly initiative by a Member of Parliament for Tampines Changkat, Ms. Irene Ng, and its purpose is to create a butterfly-conducive habitat for residents and nature enthusiasts to enjoy. There were quite a lot of butterflies, including the plain tiger, common grass yellow, and the common mormon. While there was an abundant population of butterflies, we did not find any caterpillars or butterfly eggs present on the leaves. Also, we did notice predators such as lizards, and we believe that they might contribute to the lack of butterfly offspring at the garden. Considering the fact that these predators are in a controlled environment where they will not be able to escape, this might be of serious detriment to the current butterfly population, and we hope that the committee of the garden will take measures in order to solve this problem. Phylum is in the process of building butterfly parks. It has recently constructed a butterfly enclosure in Raffles Institution Junior College. As part of a research project on the blue glassy tiger, they have created a microhabitat for the butterfly. The butterflies are not introduced into this environment yet. However, this is still a commendable effort to conserve and research on butterflies in order to learn more about them and to protect them in the long run. Evidently, it is colossally consequential how the butterflies in our environment are living, being treated and taken care of. Our group has taken on a good front to help in promoting the awareness of the existence of butterflies all around us, and how they serve as an essential cornerstone to the beauty of the environment, as well as the state of relationships between animals and plants. Next time you walk around the park or a garden, do be conscious of these precious divine beings and admire their flittering about to help our environment grow. We hope that you guys have learned more about butterflies and will play a part in conserving butterflies. Remember, butterflies are crucial in nature and we should do our part to protect them. Thank you for watching this documentary. Goodbye.